wet. Your fingers rest on my face. I fall from myself. You smile to yourself. Clouds shift across like a mountain of green. Too many nights turn into days. If they could all only end this way, hey, 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 hey. I'm calling your name. You're calling my name. Oh, we are one in a happiness. Loving you means whatever you say. Trust we will always make this way.
This is Mike Green with One Eye Open Productions, and we are interviewing two artists, local artists now, Heather Harris and
Stephanie Friedman.
Okay, and tell us about your display here.
Sure. What would you like to know?
This is pretty good. Well,
the teacher and me.
What? Yeah, right. Exactly. What? What is this art gallery? What's the name of it? Where is it located? Who owns it? And what are y'all doing here tonight?
This is the Diaz Gallery. It's located in Plainview Gardens on South First and Alcon in South Austin. It's owned by Adam Diaz and his mom, Sandra. And they have art shows within the house, so it's kind of nursery on the outside, gallery on the inside. And the title of our show is Migrations and Integrations. I'm Migration, not Integrations. And I have 19 pieces that are all sewn, fabric panels, and the common theme is birds, hence the name Migration. And my work is, I have 14 pieces, it's metal, digital, and photography, all mixed together, and some painting.
And what's today?
Sorry, today's the opening.
That's what I wanted to know. Thank you very much. You did a great
job.
And it's November 30th, right, at approximately 6:30 p.m. Thank you very much. We're going to go inside in a few minutes and see how things look. Cool.
I'm calling.
think about a week before I had to hang the show. All the fabric is actually from IKEA. I love the colors, and I just kind of have fun with different stitching and patterns. This next piece is called Primary Birds, and I had the idea of a carousel or a mobile turning for this one. This one is called Gray Gardens Birds, though I guess one of the birds would be wearing a headscarf, which is really Gray Gardens. And the material comes from a variety of places. I have some vintage fabric I get from yard sales or estate sales, and I buy new fabric online, Japanese imports. Some of this fabric was used in a quilt I had for a wedding, so I kind of keep track of all the scraps to use them again. This piece is called Bubblegum Birds. I thought it was kind of fun and colorful, and who doesn't love bubblegum? Over here is the Mustard Birds, kind of having a 70s aesthetic in color palette. Over here you'll recognize some of the same fabric as over there. This one's called the One-Winged Bird. It's easy to spot. These are formation birds. I'm kind of playing around with the different paths the birds take. Again, migration is the title of the show. So you can follow the stitching to see where the birds go, kind of within the different elements. And then I sort of have a crazy cool background of some vintage fabric scraps. This one is called Circus Birds. Kind of reminding you of the big top and the megaphone and the marker. This one is called Wordle Birds. It's kind of similar to one over there with the mobile embroidery. And then on this wall, this piece over here is called the 4th of July Birds because I thought the pattern of buttons sort of resembled fireworks as well as the color scheme being fairly patriotic. This is also another one titled Formation Birds. It's kind of in the same family as that one over there. And again, you can see the stitching kind of follow the paths around the birds. This one over here is called Puppet Birds because I thought of the way that the threads came down that looked like these two birds here were suspended like puppets. And I had some fun here embroidering faces on them, which I haven't done for all of them. So I like trying different things for different pieces. This one here in red is called Over the Moon Birds, or could be subtitled Love Birds, because it looked like kind of a sort of constellation in the sky, and then the fabric sort of looks like it would glow in the dark. This one over here is called the Family Birds, and it's probably going to go to my sister-in-law, who just told me she's pregnant. It's kind of the idea of a little one, then just kind of a family together, sort of baby pink and baby blue colors. This one is called Hurricane Birds. It's kind of a companion piece to the birds. And you can kind of see the vortex in the center with all the stitching and sort of the same expressions on the birds' faces. And these fabrics also came from a mixture of places, from big fabric stores to old clothes and pillows. Like I said, I had like 4 overflowing boxes of fabric scraps. This piece right here is called the Kinetic Birds. You may recognize it from the postcard that we mailed out. It's also sort of the same idea as the bubblegum birds that are on the other side of the room, where I played around with picking up the colors with circles, with the thread, as your eye kind of balls around the different paths that the birds take. This one here is called Invisible Birds because the birds themselves blend into the background and you have to pick them out. I think there's 5 birds on this one. It's sort of a Where's Waldo birds. This one is called Math Birds because it was the first one that I made with this idea of making different angles from circle to circle, and it reminded me of math.
Thanks, Jeff. Yes.
I'll give you a little tour around the room here. All of the abstracts originate from landscape. For instance, that one originates from that one right there. This one right here originates from this one right here. And I have my, one of my favorites, my peacock picture right there, and the abstract that is created from it right there. I like to do both abstracts and landscapes, so I have one of each normally. That one's called Red Bridge, and you can see the detail in the lily pads there as they extend out from the pond in the picture. And that is the abstract from Red Bridge. Hojas Rojas, red flowers in Spanish. And then the abstract from that one is right here. And then the last pieces here are these two.
Leaves on the grass, gentle and wet, and the stress of my head. I fall from myself, you smile to yourself. Clouds drift across like a mountain of green. Too many nights turn into days. With the rolling in the rain.
Tonight from 7 to 10 is our art opening, so we hope to get a good crowd.
And if you miss tonight, come on by later.
The gallery is open, I think, Tuesday through Sunday from around 10 to 7, and then 10 to 5 on Sunday.
Attractions that you're laughing with all that you